Hello children, welcome back. So, we'll discuss about tropical rainforests and adaptation in animals. Today's class, I'll tell you about three animals. First one is about big cats. Second one is about elephants. And third one is about red-eyed frog. So, let us discuss the adaptations of these three animals. Let us start with big cats. What do you mean by big cats? Big cats means lion, tiger, cheetah, etc. These animals are usually found in tropical rainforest, okay? Tropical rainforest, what is the climatic condition? It is very hot, very humid. Very hot, very humid. Because of high humidity, there is a very good rainfall throughout the year. Okay, rainfall is heavy and throughout the year. Because of this reason, these tropical rainforests are also called as evergreen forest. They are green throughout the year. They do not shed the leaves. And they get rainfall throughout the year. So they are always green. Always green, full of greenery and levels of greenery also. Shrubs are there, which is very small, first level. Herbs are there. First herbs are there, next shrubs are there. After that, there are somewhat taller plants, and foliage of higher plants will be on the top. You can see level stratification also in this forest. Right, we'll come back to discuss about big cats. Big cats like lion, tiger, cheetah, usually they have, first adaptation is, they have either brown skin or with black stripes or black dots, etc. So this type of skin helps in camouflaging. Camouflaging means, in our previous class we have already discussed that camouflaging is nothing but merging with surroundings, having some color or pattern in such a way that it helps in the animal to merge with surroundings, right? So this merging with surroundings or camouflaging helps the organisms in two ways. One is it catches prey. To catch the prey, it is useful. Second one is it can protect itself from predators. From predators, it can protect itself. In case of big cats, it is only a fearful predator. There is no question of protection from predator. So in big cats, it is helpful in to catch the prey. Whenever any big cat has to catch a prey, what does it do? It waits there. It waits there in the surround where it can camouflage itself in such a surrounding. It waits for a long time. Then it hunts the animal. So for at that time, organism should not identify. Okay, prey should not identify that here tiger, lion, cat is there. And it should not run away. So that is very useful for this big cat. Second thing, okay, let me rub this. So first adaptation of big cats is they have brown skin and black stripes or black dots that help that to camouflage itself with the surroundings. Next, second adaptation is they have very good eyesight. So you can see some of the animals have blurred vision. You take some of the creatures, small creatures have compound eyes, their vision is blurred. And some of the animals have they don't have color vision, and some animals can see some of the colors, but in case of big cats, they have very good eyesight, they can see all colors, and moreover their eyes are on the front of face, on the front of face. So unlike any organisms, like for example snake, it has snake is not having a vision. Okay, you can see squirrels and some organisms that have side eyes. Eyes are on sides. You can see for rabbit also, eyes are on side. If the eyes are on sideways, the vision will not be clear. For animals, we have front eyes, our vision is very clear. So same like that in case of this big cats also, eyes are on the front side, and this helps them through, this helps in the very clear vision. Okay. They can identify their prey, they can identify the organisms that are in front of it, and they have very sharp, strong claws. Sharp and strong claws help it to hunt the prey. Usually when it is hunting its prey, it just puts its paws, or it just hunts with its throws its paws on the organism on which it has to hunt. Okay, usually it catches the prey in this region so that its claws are directly going into the neck and cutting the blood vessels, the main blood vessels that pass on this sides, and this sides will cut off. Okay, we have two main blood vessels here, two main blood vessels here, most of the organisms have. So when it catches on the neck region, immediately those blood vessels are cut off and the animal dies off very easily. Okay, when it has to hold its cubs, it does not catch on the front side of the neck, it catches on the back side. Okay, so along with claws, it has very sharp canines. These sharp canines, along with the sharp claws, help it to hunt very easily, efficiently. So it does not have like us four different types of teeth, incisors, canines, premolars and molars, and these are all not there. It has only canines of different sizes. These canines help that organism to hunt the prey very efficiently. And one more different adaptation that is seen in claws is these claws can go inside the paws. Okay, they can go inside fur and paws. How? See, you can see in Marvel movies, we can see that the person who want to hunt from fingernails will come outside, iron nails, something like that. So in case of these big cats, it's real. You catch the paw of that big tiger or big lion. Usually those who zookeepers can catch the paws and all, they are trained how to handle with them. So if they catch like this, those paws will come outside, and when this claws will be this much small, they are not as long as those Marvel movies. Very small claws, very nicely bent for hunting very efficiently. They'll come outside, and when it's not hunting and all, it goes inside. Okay, simply goes inside, and you cannot see, you see only fur and very small nail. Okay, so that is one more adaptation. Fifth, it can run fast. It can run very fast. So usually it has a very heavy body. In spite of having a very heavy body, height is very good, but still they can run fast because of their muscle buildup is very good. Okay, their muscles are very strong and they can run efficiently. Usually what they do, they hide in a safe place, secret place to hunt the prey. And sometimes, you know, there are some animals which are having sharp hearing sense, like take for example deer have very good sharp hearing sense. Whenever they listen a small bit of noise, they'll run away. So that is the reason why these big cats stay still. They do not move at all, they stay still, and they wait for the right opportunity to hunt. Even if they get a small noise, those animals can run off. If that animal started to run, these animals, big cat, should be able to run behind them, catch the prey and hunt them. For that reason, they have a very good fast. They are very fast, they run very fast. Okay, so these are the adaptations that are seen in big cats. They have brown skin, stripes and dots that help in camouflaging. They have very good eyesight and the eyes are in front of the face. And they have sharp, strong claws, which go inside fur and claws. And they have sharp canines. It can even run very fast, okay? So that is about the adaptations that are seen in big cats. Next, elephants. Elephants have their own adaptations. Elephants are very large, heavy body animals. They are also found in tropical rainforests. And what are the adaptations that are found in elephants? Let us see. Elephants, let us first talk about its trunk. It has a long trunk. This trunk is a long nose. Like in any other organism, it helps in sensation of smell. It also helps in breathing. And the sensation of smell for this elephant is very strong. It can sense even a small smell of predator. It can smell the grass which it want to feed. It has very good sensation of smell. Apart from that, this trunk of this elephant also is helpful as a hand. It can feed itself. It can feed itself with the help of this long trunk. How? Usually you might have seen some elephants at the temples and all, you give banana sweet, it holds that banana, it rolls its trunk inside and keeps in the mouth, okay? It can even cut branches. With the help of this long trunk, it extends its trunk to a height, it cuts those branches and again it rolls inside and keeps it inside the mouth, okay? It helps. It can even drink water. Drink water with the help of this long trunk. At that time, it acts as a straw. Like a straw, it dips itself, its nose in the water, it drinks. And it can even bathe itself. Okay, whenever it want to get, it takes the water inside the trunk and it baths itself, right? Those are the advantages of trunk. Now, another adaptation that is seen in these organisms is tusk. It has two long tusks which are modified forms of incisors. Okay, these are incisors. Apart from incisors, it has two incisors. It has four molars inside. That's all. It has only these six teeth. These molars are helpful in grinding and chewing. They are helpful in grinding and chewing the food. What is the advantage of these incisors? Incisors are helpful for removing bark. When it want to eat any plant parts, it should not have something like hard bark over that. So it will scratch that bark and remove it with the help of these trunks. And it also kills predators and protects itself. So usually whenever any organism comes to hunt it, it pokes with the help of sharp tusk. So usually organisms do not prefer to come towards it because of the fear of tusk. So it helps in protection from any predators, right? Next, it has long ears, trumpet like ears. These long ears act as fan, okay? Whenever it want to air itself, that it will shake that trunk like trumpet like ears, and it will air itself. It scares away the flies, that's it, on its back. Usually animals have long tail, but in case of elephant their tail is short, so it uses its ear. When it flaps its ears, all the flies that are sitting on the back will fly away. And it has very good hearing sense. Very good hearing sense because of that long trumpet like ears, which can receive all the signals that come from different directions. It has very good hearing sense. And it also has very good, well, right here, wide paths, wide feet. This wide feet of elephants help it to balance its body. Huge body, if it is having something like hooves on the lower feet, will it be able to balance its body? It goes inside, okay? So it can easily go inside because of the heavy body. To avoid that, it has four pillar like heavy feet, okay? This feet helps it to balance its body and prevents sinking into soil. So these are the various adaptations that are found in elephant. Let's summarize once. Elephants have long trunk, which is nothing but a long nose. It helps in smelling. It has a very strong sense of smell. It is also helpful in breathing. Apart from smelling and breathing, it can feed itself with the help of trunk. It can cut branches. It can drink water. It can bathe itself. Next adaptation of elephant is it has tusks. Second adaptation is it has tusk. This tusk is nothing but incisors. Two incisors are present and four molars are present for elephant. And it does not have premolars and canines because it's not a hunting animal. Canines are present in animals which tear the flesh. Okay, we tear the flesh also, we cut the green vegetables also. So we have both canines as well as incisors. But in case of these organisms, they do not tear the flesh. They are not eating any flesh. So they do not need canines. They have only incisors and molars. Molars are helpful in chewing and grinding the food. Okay, what is the use of this tusk? With the help of the tusk, it removes the bark, upper layer of bark. And it also fears away the predators. It kills the predators and protects itself. Next adaptation that is seen in elephants is long ears, which act as fans. It can air itself with the help of these long ears. It can scare away the flies that sit on its back. It has very good sense of hearing. And it has wide feet which help it to balance its body and prevent sinking into the soil. Right? Now let us see the adaptation of third animal. Red-eyed frog. This is another creature that is found in the tropical rainforest. So usually we know that frogs are generally found either on land or in water, but this is a creature which is found on trees rather than in water. Red-eyed frog does not stay in water. It stays on trees, so it is also called as red-eyed tree frog. Okay, we'll understand the features of this red-eyed tree frog first. It has back that is green in color and lower body, that means lower side towards its abdomen and all, lower body is cream color in appearance, and it has feet with fingers separate and sticky feet. So usually when you see the frog, observe the frog that is found in our locality, next time you'll see that feet is webbed like this. This webbed feet help the frog to swim very efficiently. But in case of this red-eyed frog, the fingers are separate like this. There are pod-like structures in the front which help it to stick on the trees. So this is the structure of the feet of a red-eyed frog. Okay, fingers are separate. There are knob-like structures at the end which helps it to stick over the trees, and they are very sticky. And as the name itself says, it has red eyes that bulge out, bulging out red eyes. this bulging out red eyes are not inside the socket, they are outside the socket. That's why they are called as bulging out red eyes. Okay. So everything is an adaptation. All this which we have discussed is an adaptation. If the frog, take for example, first green back. Green color helps it to camouflage itself with the surroundings. Camouflaging means it can merge itself with the surroundings. So in case of frog, two advantages of it. Camouflaging helps it to protect itself from animals like eagles. It can protect itself from animals like snakes that prime on the trees. So one advantage is it can protect itself from predators. Second, it can hide itself from the prey also. When it is hunting any insects, it will hide inside the leaves and hunt the insect. Insects will not be able to identify it. Right? This feet which are sticky feet help it to stay on trees. Stick its feet on the trees and it stays on trees. Usually it stays inside leaves. It hides inside leaves. It hides itself inside the leaves and stays there. And one more thing is, it is a nocturnal creature. Since most of the insects are active during the daytime, it is also active in the night time. It is also active in the night time. Animals which are active in the night time and rest in the daytime are called as nocturnal creatures. And this is also a nocturnal creature. It hunts its food in the night time. Okay. What else? Other adaptations. It has a very good eyesight. It has a very good eyesight. That helps it to identify its prey, and along with that, it also has, it is a carnivore that feeds on insects, and insects are very abundant in the tropical rainforest. It is a carnivore that feeds on insects. Right? So that is about red-eyed frog. Let's summarize once. Red-eyed frog lives on trees. That's why it is called as red-eyed tree frog. It has a back that is green in color. Lower body is creamy in color. Feet are separate and sticky feet. Eyes are red and bulged out. Okay, the advantage of red bulged eyes. It can protect, because of this red bulged eyes, it can protect itself from the predators that come to hunt. How it protects from the predators? See, whenever any predator comes to hunt it, usually the eyes of this frog are closed when it hides itself in the trees so as to camouflage with the surrounding. Whenever any predator comes to hunt it, it opens its eyes. So for a few seconds, that animal or organism that came to hunt that gets frightened. That few seconds of gap is enough for the frog to escape itself from that predator. In that way, it protects itself. Okay, so this is one more adaptation. Okay, so green color helps in camouflaging. Sticky feet help it to stay on trees. It lives usually on inside the leaves. That means that leaf foliage, group of leaves will be there inside. It will hide itself. It's a nocturnal creature, active during the night time. It feeds on insects on the night time. It has a very good eyesight. And it is a carnivore. Since carnivore and insects are very abundant in tropical rainforest, it feeds on these insects which are found in this forest. Okay, so with this we have completed three animals, big cats, elephants and red-eyed frog is completed. In our next class we will discuss about three other animals that are found in this tropical rainforest. Okay children, bye.